of you, but there are things in your past that are holding you back. You are able to step into the supernatural because there are things that are just pulling you back. Every time you try to move into the next level, there is this voice behind you, a condemning voice. It's not too late. It's not too late.
Dumelang, sanibonani, and good evening. This is Pastor Sammy, and once again, I am so excited and so glad that you decided to join me on this program tonight, Let My People Go. Tonight I have a powerful and a life-changing message for you. I'm talking about you watching me right now, you sitting at home. And I just want to encourage you, if you're sitting on your own, I want you to call your family, call your kids, call your husband, call your wife, because today's word might just be that word that you have been waiting for, that word that is going to take you from where you are right now to the next level and the next chapter of your life. I know there are things that are happening in your life right now, and you don't really understand what is the cause of all this challenges, all this suffering and all this misfortune that I am experiencing, that my family is experiencing. I was praying before I put together this message, God, Mudimu, let me know what is it that people are going through and what is the cause, or what are some of the causes of the things that they are going through. And Mudimu unabua le bophelo ba ka re ngwanak ke tlo fa lentswe ka jeno le tlo lokolla batho. I'm going to give you a word that is going to liberate and set people free. Lentswe la Mudimu le re, you shall know the truth and the truth shall set you free. And I want to assure you that tonight you are going to be free. I'm going to be speaking about something that to some people it sounds like a myth, or it sounds like just a saying. And to some, it sounds like something that's really not there, or a figure of speech. I'm going to talk about something that is called the dark cloud. Liru, leli fifi. You know, have you ever been in a place where it feels like, it looks like, or it even sounds like you are walking under a dark cloud? So I'm going to take you through a story in the Bible of a man, Elungur, at some point in his life, he experienced what seemed like a dark cloud upon his life. It seemed like there was a dark cloud that was hanging over him. And this man is a man by the name of Job. A man by the name of Job. I just want to read you two or three verses and you will see, how did this man get through this, what we call the dark cloud? If you read in the book of Job, chapter 1, I will read the first verse. First verse says, there was once a man named Job in the land of Uz. He was blameless, a man of complete integrity. He feared God and he stayed away from evil. Let us just stop there. Here we are talking about what the Bible calls a good man. Job was not a perfect man. The Bible doesn't say Job was a perfect man, but the Bible just says he was a good man. He was a noble man who did all that was right and tried and stayed away from everything that was evil. Most of us, we would think that just because you are good and you're not doing anything bad, then things won't happen. Crazy and bad things will not happen to you because you live a blameless life. You're staying away from evil. But let us jump to verse 13 and see what happened to this good man, this blameless man, this man who walked in integrity, not a perfect man, but a man who tried by all means to stay away from anything that is evil. The Bible says one day, I want you to listen to me. The Bible says one day, when Job's sons and daughters were feasting at the oldest brother's house, a messenger arrived at Job's home with this news. Your oxen were plowing with the donkeys feeding beside them when the Sabians raided us. They stole all the animals and killed all the farmhand. I'm the only one who escaped. Mamela, Job, in one day, a messenger came carrying news that Job was not expecting. I'm sure, and on that day, I'm sure when Job woke up on that day, he thought that was going to be another day, a normal day. He never anticipated any tragedy that it would happen on that day. He thought it was going to be a day like any other day. But the Bible says it was a different day. Job in that day, he lost his oxen. He lost his donkeys. He lost. And the messenger says, I'm the only one. And Job was sitting there, oh my God, this is something terrible. What worse that could happen? I'm talking to somebody who has been going through and and he's saying, what is the worst that could happen? I think I have lost enough. But Job, it did not end there. Then there was a second messenger. While this one was speaking, another messenger arrived with the news. The fire of God has fallen from heaven and burned all your sheep and all your shepherds. I am the only one who escaped. Everything that was valuable to you within one moment, it was burned down to ashes. Remember, the Bible said Job was a good man. The Bible said Job was a blameless man, was a faithful man. He was a man who did what was good and tried to stay away from evil. But we see this great man, he didn't think that things like this happen to people like us. You know, you are sitting there and say, you know what? I have tried to be the best person that I can be. I've tried to be a good person. I'm not a perfect person, but the way dintho tse nhlahellang ka teng e ka re ka nnete ho na le leru le letsho le ka hoduma hloho yaka. It feels like I'm walking under a dark cloud. I seem to be losing every day. Every day things are going from bad to worse. Am I talking to you right now? Uduti, you've just lost things. Uduti ona jwalo o lahletswe ke mosebetsi. How get out last year? Kimu sebeti musadiwa how about siya? How musadiwa waketa usiya? Wonku abana bahao. Orosaru duti fatso hutu koloya how it all atu. From bad to worse, you think heaven na kili iru lele itu leka uduma shoya. A dark cloud that is hanging over my head. This was a good man. This was not a perfect man. What am I saying, Letsatsi Lakajeno? Many of you have been and you are still experiencing a dark cloud. Kaud mabupilo bahao. Liru. Lelitu. Liru lena lietang. Liru lena lenka musebetu wahao. Liru lena lenka banabahao. Hautsebur banabahao ba baba juwa king. Hunale mufiri firi karale la palahao. Lirulena lenka monna wa hao ha o tsibudutse mo mo lenteng ha o tsibe monna hao kae lirulena lenka bana ba lirulena lenkile mosadi wa o setse le bana ka tlung mosadi o tsamaile ke lirulena le ka o duma hloyao. It is this dark cloud that is taking everything that seemed to be valuable bophelong ba hao. This dark cloud lenka di property tsa hao. This dark cloud lenka di businesses tsa hao di a tshwatleya ka baka la lirulena. People are plotting against you. business in your house, but about to work hard. People are betraying you. But you walk adding business in Lebanon, all of a sudden there's betrayal. There's a dark cloud that is hanging upon you. Your marriage is falling apart. You have been struggling. Some of you say, Muruti, ki fitile ka ra lirulena, ki selimo, ki tsamaya ka tlasa lirulena. Some of you, it's been 5 years I've been under this dark cloud. Some of you, Muruti, I can't even remember a time when things were good in my life. It seems like my life has just been a constant battle. E ka re nan thwengwe le mo ya ka tshwanetse ke lwane. Hore ke thola mosebetsi tshwanetse ke lwane. Hore I must keep that job. I have to fight to keep that job. For me to keep that business, I have to keep fighting. It seems that for me to keep this marriage together, I have to fight for it. I have to fight him to keep him. I have to fight her to keep her. I have 20 kilwane, ke re 20 kilwane le bana ba ka hore ba gone ba ka tlung. I have to fight a dark cloud over my head. Liruleletso. Nothing seemed to be working out. Ke bua le wena jwale. Nothing is working out for you. I see you right now. Uri, nothing is working for me. Whatever that I try to do, somehow I sebet. Ha ke qala business ha isebetsi. Ha ke re ke batla mosebetsi ha ke o thole. Kapo ha ke qeta ho thola wa fela mosebetsi. Within few months I lose that job. My life is stagnant on that. Ke leru, a dark cloud over hanging over my head. The Bible speaks about the enemy, the devil went to God. Mudimu Satan ya ho mudimu re, hey man, ke bone motho ona ba reng ke jobo. I can see you are blessed. I can see mara ke kopa ho motesta. The enemy knows what God has for you. The enemy has been looking at your marriage. Are I wanna see how I can destroy lenyalo la motho ona. The enemy you bone business ya ho tswella, your relationship di tswella, ministry wa ho tswella, kereke ya ho tswella. The enemy went because the Bible says the enemy is a great accuser of the brethren. He accuses. He will go as with the mudimuri, eh, uchena because of mohlonolo faditse. Eh, uchena go bane hana chelete, mo fe chelete fela o tla bona. Eh, uchena because una le chelete, nka chelete. He is the accuser. He went to God and accused Job because of how good Job is. The enemy, there's a conversation. There is a conversation that the enemy is having behind your back. There has been plots behind your back. Tsene di etsa hala wena o sa di bone. Wena o bone ka reng dintho di a senyeya fela. Ha o tsebe hore hona le dintho, hona le batho, hona le memeya e sebetsang behind the scene to make sure hore ntho tseo tse o di rapelletseng ha o di thole. To make sure lenyalo le ho la tshwatlea. To make sure bana ba ba hao wa senyeya ka bona ha ona mo ba yang teng. To make sure the business ya ho ya tshwatlea. There are enemies that are behind the scenes that are accusing you, that are plotting evil against your life. And hence, they are around your life and they are above you as a cloud, a dark cloud. You know, the Bible talks about a cloud of witnesses. Liru la dipaki le re shebile, who are rooting for us, who are encouraging us, but at the same time, because the enemy also wants to be involved, there's a cloud liena, a cloud of accusations, a cloud of enemies. Liona iyemika uduma haura, you will never succeed. Lenyalo lo la holi keke la tswella, mosebetsi o ke kwa uthola, tshelete ye o ke kwa ithola. There's a cloud. As much as there's a cloud of witnesses, there's also a cloud of evil, a cloud of accusation that has been waging against. Huna le mantswe a buang behind the scene concerning your life, speaking against bophelo ba hao. Wena wa ipotsa hore why nna ka ra lelapa lena e ka re ke nna fela ya sotleyang? Why ka ra lelapa lena e ka re ke nna fela sa sebetseng? Why ka ofela bana ba hesi ba nyetswe ke nna fela sa nyalwang? Why ka ofela bana le bana ke nna fela sa beng le bana? Why ka ofela hesu batho ba tswella ka di business na ke tswelle ka ofela bana ba hesu ba driver but I'm not driving. It is a dark cloud. Hona di ntho tse buang behind the scene against your life. Hona le satana ile mo modimo a lo bua against job. And ha gutla mo the enemy wreaked havoc against the life of Job. There's a lot of jealousy that you are not aware of. When you think king e batho ba ka jealousy tsang yona because I don't have that much. But you don't understand, the enemy also knows the plans the modimo ana le tsona concerning your life. He knows the plans that God has for your life. That's why he will go behind and try to cause havoc. He'll go behind and try to disturb you and try to depress you because he's aware of the things that God has planned for your life. There are evil forces. Why don't you listen to me? The Bible says our warfare, our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against rulers, against principalities, against powers of dark forces. The battle is not against batwa bo shebile bo nana re ke bana ba o lwantsa. It's bigger than that. There are forces. The devil himself, he went to God and accused and said, "Mfeye, I'm going to do this over his life." The enemy knows what God is planning to do in your life, and they will come at you in the form of a dark cloud. And this dark cloud, it will come in many forms. Number one, witchcraft. There will be a cloud of witchcraft. Babambalona la iputa rintwa dietsa lekin. There's a cloud of witchcraft. Yabuloi esebetsana ngkhahlano lwena bazalwane batho ba modimo le batho ba se ba satsibu modimo ntwe bitswang buloi te. People, there are people who are working against you using witchcraft against your life, because a lot of things you can't pinpoint how it's because there are forces, there are evil powers that you are not aware of behind the scene. You are not aware that why there are people behind the scenes trying to sabotage you. Why you put her in 20 daily right, you were due for a promotion, but all of a sudden it just falls apart. There are voices behind the scenes that were speaking against your elevation, speaking against your breakthrough and your promotion. There are voices that were speaking against your marriage. Baya homo sadu wa hao babu edi ntote mpi ka wena. Baya homo na wa hao babu edi ntote mpi wena. Babu edi ntote mpi among themselves, speaking against your marriage. There are many other forms telling you that this dark cloud will come against your life. There are words that have been spoken against you. Let me tell you something. Words are powerful. I'm going to say that again. Words are powerful. That's why the power of life and death is not living la muntu. Do you know who the motor akau lawyer kali limi? Do you know a person can bewitch you using their tongue? And you will never succeed. You will never succeed. I can hear some of the voices about it. When you will never be married. You will never be married. You will never be successful. Your business will never thrive. Kimantu abuang, and those words are powerful. But today, mudimu rumme wen, I have been sent to you. The fact that Mudimu is aware of all these things, in the next few minutes, I'm going to pray for each and every one of you. So hona jwale ke na le nomoro mona e hlaelang ke nomoro ya WhatsApp ke nomoro ke kopa o nromelle molaetsa before ke rapele ke kopa o nke phone ya hao and o mbolele hore ke ngwana le rule. What is it that this cloud is causing? What kind of a rain e le rule na le khosa modimo wa bophelo ba hao? King, is it lenyalo la hao? Take that phone and begin now and tell me muruti. This cloud has taken my husband. This dark cloud is wreaking havoc in my marriage. Write to me right now. I'm waiting for you. I've got my phone. Right now, write to me and tell me. I can see. I don't see. The dark cloud is upon my children. There is havoc. This dark cloud is upon my workplace. Mo ke sebetsang teng. Akompulele wena before ke rapele kopa ombulele hore dali, what is this cloud doing wena bophelong ba hao? So that I can pray. I have been anointed. I have been empowered to speak and rebuke this cloud. This dark cloud the oduma bophelo ba hao. The Lord has anointed me. The Lord has empowered me. The Lord has sent me on rumetsi hore ke tlotlosa leruleo so that I can remove that dark cloud upon your life. I did not just come up with this. I did not just thumb suck it. But the Lord commanded me, say, Mwanaka, as much as Job, ona li liru le luduma hai, ona li liru le kauduma banabak. And I need, you have the power, you have been given the power to remove it. Mpulele hona jo, I'm waiting for you. See, messages are coming in, messages. Liru le nela di chelete taka. My money is just burning like ashes. I don't know what's happening. Liru le na ka reke reke, there's havoc. My church is Israel after lockdown. I don't know where's everybody. Everybody's just gone, disappeared. Kili fin liru le hona jo. Right, I see your messages. I'm going to pray for you right now. I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to do something after I pray. I want you to be very udulemo. Sit there. Don't move anywhere. We are almost coming to an end. I'm going to do something because I want to. I was praying to God and saying, Mudimo, I am not able to go to these people and touch them. I'm not able to go and pray over them. Mobaling ting matlungabon. I'm not able to go. I need a way. What is it that I can do? A simple way of being in contact, of connecting with each of these people. I want a way of just connecting with you so that kihono bali connection lo ena pray for you. Mobaling ting. I'm gonna tell you about this. But for now, I want you right now. We're swearing to you. You've told me. I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to stretch my hand towards you. I'm going to pray right now. I'm going to rebuke that cloud. I'm going to rebuke that dark cloud. Hona joal. I want you more in thing upamise letsola hao. Lift up your hands where you are. I want you to lift up your hands. It's your hand up. Lift up your hands. Don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. This is between me and you and God. It's got nothing to do with anybody around the house. I want to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus. Here is a person and chebeleting wana juale. Their hand is up. They have been going through a lot. They've been going through pain. They've been going through suffering. They've been going through struggle. And God, there has been a dark cloud upon their lives that has been wreaking havoc. They lost jobs. They lost houses. They lost families. They lost marriages. Everything has just been a mess and everything has been falling apart. There are words against their lives. There have been witchcraft against their lives. Hona joale, that dark cloud that is upon these people, I rebuke you right now. In the name of Jesus, you shall not be part of these people's life. Honestly, I send the blowing spirit of God to go and blow away this cloud. Like a wind. I'm sending a wind that will blow away that cloud. And honestly, the spirit of God is blowing away that wind. It's blowing away that wind. And as it is doing so, you are going to see great things happening in your life. You're going to see mighty things. You're going to see breakthrough happening in your life because the cloud, the dark cloud has been removed from your life. In Jesus' mighty name, that dark cloud has been removed. You are going to see great and wonderful things happening in your life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to do something. When you see things happening, that's the number. It comes directly to me and my prayer partner and my prayer warriors. We're praying for you. When something happens, I'm expecting great testimony. Tell me now, what is it that has happened? Say, Muruti, hey, after your prayer, I felt the Spirit of God moving in me. I said before that I want a way. I was praying to God, Gerimutimo. I want a way of being able to connect with these people. Nkakona Jwangore, as much as I can't reach them, as much as I can't go matlong abona, I can't go mobalinting, I can't go dipetelo, what is it that I can do? And the Lord reminded me of something powerful, that there was a woman with an issue of blood. When she went to Jesus, Jesus was not in a position to literally go to her and to touch her and pray for her. But this woman, all that she did, because she believed in the power of God, she believed in the power that is upon Jesus, the anointing. All that she did, she touched the hem of Jesus. She went and touched part of Jesus' clothing. And the Bible says power came out of Jesus and it touched her and she was well. And another thing, in Acts 11, God says to me, look at what I did. The Bible says God did extraordinary miracles through Paul, through the man of God Paul, so that even the handkerchiefs and the aprons that touched him were taken to the sick and their illnesses were cured and evil spirits left them. I want to send you something. Elungwe, it's going to be a way for me to connect with you. I was trying to think of any way, can I go and whatever. I want to send you something that is going to connect me and you. And when you have this particular item of clothing, I'm going to send you this, what you see on the screen. It is a t-shirt. This t-shirt, it is simply written, I believe. And it is quoting, all things are possible to them that believe. When you put on that t-shirt, adding I believe, that means whatever prayer that I am making concerning your life, whatever power and anointing that I'm releasing, it is confirmed by you when you put that on and say, I believe. I receive it and I believe. And when you do that, I believe me, the power of God is going to touch you. It is not just an ordinary t-shirt, but it is a confirmation. It is a declaration. It is an agreement. I want you to be a miracle partner, Yaka. I want to release, I want to see miracles happening in your life. And I want to be able to touch you. But I can't go to you, Kilotswara. I can't go and touch you. But when I touch these and they become part of you, we are in covenant. We are in communion. Whatever mudimweki rapelang is going to happen in your life. That is the way that I can be able to reach you. So I want you to take these numbers now. I just need 100 people. I'm going to send these, 100 of them, to 100 people that I'm going to get into a miracle covenant till when. When you say, I believe, everything ekibuilung concerning your life, it shall come to pass. Take these numbers. Call me now. SMS me now and say, I want this t-shirt. I want to say, I believe. Whatever that God has in store. How cooler when you put it on, I believe. I believe that all things are possible. I believe it. Whatever, when you want to pray, you don't know what to say, you put that on. You are in agreement with me. Concerning your life. Unfortunately, I have run out of time. Completely out of time. I wish I could continue and speak to you some more. But please follow me on my Facebook page, Semira Lukhulela. Every day I share scriptures and you'll get to know. I'm going to be traveling and coming to you now and praying for you wherever you are. Follow me on my Facebook page. Talk to me there. You'll see me. Semira Lukhulela. Instagram, Semira Lukhulela. Just get in touch with me. I want to know more about you and I want to be able to serve you even more. And I care for you and I'm trusting and believing God for great things concerning your life. I am going to see you again same time, same week on this channel, Gauw TV 265. Amen.